timeless concepts from physics helpline. This is a video tutorial series through which we will sharpen our problem solving skill. First, we will analyze the problem on hand to find the related concepts. Then using these, we will develop a method which will produce the solution. This will help the students aspiring to get into IIT to understand the much needed advanced theories and applications in physics. In this video tutorial, we will discuss a problem on the potential difference in a capacitor network. The question is as follows. 5 capacitors and 2 resistors are connected to a DC source of EMF 200 volts and internal resistance 1 ohm as shown in the figure, where C1 and C2 are 6 microfarads each and C3, C4 and C5 are 2 microfarad each. The resistances R1 and R2 are 40 ohms and 20 ohms respectively. Find the potential difference between the points A and B and between the points B and C in steady state. Before proceeding to solve the problem, let us recall the related concepts. In an electric circuit containing capacitors, current through each capacitor is equal to zero in steady state. When the current through a cell is zero, the potential difference across its terminals is equal to its EMF. When C1 and C2 are connected in series, charge on both the capacitors are equal and the net capacitance is given in equation 1. Potential difference across C1 and C2 are given in equation 2. And potential difference across the combination is V is equal to V1 plus V2. When C1 and C2 are connected in parallel, the voltage across both the capacitors are equal and the net capacitance is given in equation 3. And charge on the capacitors are given in equation 4. The total charge on the combination is Q is equal to Q1 plus Q2. Now, we are in a position to solve the problem in the question using these concepts. In steady state, current in the circuit is zero because every loop contains one or more capacitors. Therefore, there is no potential drop across the resistors. Hence, we remove them from the network as shown in the first figure. Now, points D and E are connected. Therefore, the 2 6 μ of capacitors are connected in parallel between the points D and B. Similarly, the 2 2 μ of capacitors are connected in parallel between the points B and G. Hence, the circuit simplifies as shown in the second figure. Now, the 2 6 μ of capacitors in parallel produce a capacitance of 12 microfarad. Similarly, the 2 μ of capacitors in parallel produce a capacitance of 4 μF. Hence, the circuit is redrawn as shown in the figure. It is evident that the branch EF is not necessary to solve the problem. Now, consider the loop ABCA. 12 μF and 4 μF in series produce a capacitance of 3 μF. Therefore, charge drawn from the source is equal to 3 μF into 200 volts, which is equal to 600 μC. Now, the potential difference across AB is equal to potential drop across the 12 μF capacitor, which is equal to 600 μC divided by 12 μF, which is equal to 50 volts. Therefore, potential difference between the points B and C is equal to 200 minus 50, which is equal to 150 volts. This completes the answer to the question. Now, we will discuss a shortcut method to arrive at the result. in series combination of capacitors, V varies as 1 by C, therefore V1 by V2 is equal to C2 by C1, which is equal to 1 by 3. This implies V2 is equal to 3V1. Therefore, V1 plus V2 is equal to 4V1, which is equal to 200 volts, which gives V1 is equal to 50 volts, and V2 is equal to 200 minus 50 is equal to 150 volts, which completes the answer to the question.